Hi everybody, my name is Michael Jessup, Global Head of Product here at ASTRO Gaming, and in today's video we're going to talk about object audio versus channel-based audio and the differences between the two. Let's get to it. So before we can dive into multi-channel audio and object-based audio, we have to start at the fundamentals, and that is, what are the types of audio that we're dealing with, and how do we deliver this multi-channel experience in these two different forms of audio? So when we're referring to audio production, there's two main types of audio. The first is linear audio. This is going to be things like TV shows, movies, things in which the sound is going to match and be played back exactly the same at the exact same timestamp every single time. Then we have non-linear content, such as video games. Every time you go to play your favorite game, the audio playback is going to be different every time based on your actions you're inputting into the game. So the audio soundscape is different every time we play, making it non-linear. So now, how do we deliver a multi-channel experience when we're talking about linear audio versus non-linear audio? As mentioned in our previous videos, the first way to get multi-channel audio out of your console is through the optical port. Now, the optical port is capable of handling two-channel uncompressed PCM audio, as well as six-channel compressed audio, and this is typically in the form of Dolby Digital 5.1. When we're playing Dolby Digital 5.1 content, again, speaking with linear and non-linear, there's two ways this is produced. If you're watching a Blu-ray or a DVD or your favorite streaming service, typically those will include a Dolby Digital 5.1 bitstream. And this is where that linear content is pre-programmed and pre-compressed into 5.1 and delivered over that optical port. Now, in a video game, because everything's done on the fly, there's a different technology that is required. Consoles employ technology called Dolby Digital Live. And what this is an audio stack that lives inside the audio subsystem of the game console. It takes that six channels of linear audio that are coming in, up to 7.1 channels for the newer consoles and the newer audio stacks, and then it compresses all of that down into a Dolby Digital bitstream, and then it's piped out over the optical port. This compression can also add in some latency. Dolby Digital typically has a compression and transmission time of roughly around 54 milliseconds. So if you're trying to inch out every single FPS, this can actually cause a little bit of lag in your audio versus gameplay experience. So we've been talking a lot about the optical port. The optical port on older consoles is just one of multiple ways to get audio in and out. We also discussed other ports as the USB port, as well as the HDMI port. Now, each of these ports, an easy way to think about this analogy is like a fire hose or a garden hose. A fire hose is a lot bigger and has a lot more throughput than a garden hose, which is smaller and only has a smaller throughput of water. Similar situation here. Optical is limited in the data that it can transfer, whereas something like HDMI has a much higher data bandwidth and can deliver much more audio throughput. For example, optical audio port can handle two channels of uncompressed PCM data versus an HDMI channel, which can handle eight channels of uncompressed PCM data. In the case of object-based audio, we're sending raw PCM uncompressed audio along with metadata and ignoring channels altogether. So now we're bringing up object-based audio. What are the big differences between channel-based audio and object-based audio? Well, the easiest way to describe this is to sit ourselves inside of an imaginary movie theater. Multi-channel audio has really been pushed forward by the theater and film industry to give the audiences a much better experience inside of the theater. Now, to do this, they've separated the theater up into channels. Right now, we have quadrants, 5.1 or 7.1 being the more common you find in home theaters and in movie theaters. Now, this works great by segmenting the theater. The problem is that a theater may house upwards of 150 speakers sitting around the audience. So when we pan something to the left channel, it may be hitting the left wall, which may contain a set of 10 speakers. So when something is panned to the left, we're hitting all 10 of those speakers at once. When something is panned to the rear left quadrant of the movie theater, it would be hitting the back left quadrant of speakers, which again would be a bank of 6, 7, maybe 8 speakers in that quadrant. So as a helicopter, for example, is panned around the movie theater, it's hitting large chunks as it hits a channel at a time. This provides for an adequate experience, but doesn't quite provide the accuracy and the precision that audio engineers are really looking for. In comes object-based audio with technologies like Dolby Atmos. And now in this scenario with object-based audio, it takes a lot of its derivatives from the gaming audio space. As opposed to dividing something up into multi-channels, we are now taking this audio and assigning it a set of XYZ coordinates in a virtual space, very much like a video game. So when we apply object-based audio to something like a movie theater and we remove channels, now with this audio system, we can address every single speaker individually. So now when this helicopter is panned around the auditorium, it's going to hit each speaker individually as it moves around the room, providing much more precision and a much more immersive effect for the audience as the sound sweeps around the audience in full 360 degrees, not only horizontally, but above you and below you as well. Game consoles now can replicate this object-based audio experience in headphones by running an audio stack on the console. Things such as Windows Sonic, DTS Headphone X, or what we like to include with our ASTRO products on the Xbox, Dolby Atmos for games. Games have been in object-based audio. Actually, since the early 90s, games have been produced in object-based audio. But because we haven't had a way to reproduce this in the home theater or in the console environment, games have been forced to be flattened down into this horizontal channel-based space. So all of these game panners take the object-based audio that's in the game, pan it down to 5.1 or 7.1 channels, and that would feed it to an audio stack such as Dolby Digital Live to be encoded into 5.1 on the fly, sent over optical port, or just sent via 5.1 or 7.1 PCM raw uncompressed out of the HDMI port. There was no way to get all that object audio and metadata out of the console or out of the game engine or out of the renderer. Now game developers have APIs available to them so they can take this object-based audio and export it out of the game and use an external rendering engine such as Dolby Atmos. The rendering engine knows how many speakers you have, whether you have 10 speakers, 15 speakers, a sound bar, or even a headset. It just knows that the sound needs to be replicated in this set of XYZ coordinates every single time. How do we bring this all together? Channel-based audio is a thing of the past. Everything is slowly moving towards object-based audio. Now, keep in mind that object audio playback that we talked about earlier in your games only works on games that are mixed in object-based audio. So make sure to start to look at your favorite games and find out, are they mix and object-based? Do they have an object-based solution? Or are they only a channel-based game? This is gonna be a mixed bag for the next couple of years as game developers are slowly converting over to object-based audio. But the trends show that everyone is moving away from channels into object-based audio, which is what we've done in our products as well. The latest generation of consoles have recently removed the optical audio port. Just because the optical port has been removed from the consoles doesn't mean that the Dolby Digital Live stack has been removed. It's still there. So you can still get Dolby Digital Live 5.1 over your HDMI bitstream. Because the optical port is being removed and because more and more games are moving towards object-based audio, we've headed that way with our products as well. We've tuned all of our mix amps and our headsets to be compatible with object-based audio rendering systems. And the reason that headsets right now don't have the ability to process object-based audio on the devices themselves is because of the processing power that's required. This is why object audio renderers currently run inside consoles like the Xbox on the built-in DSP hardware. So that's a brief summary of channel-based audio versus object-based audio. Hopefully that answers some of your questions or maybe even inspires some of you to do some of your own research on the future of game audio. I know it really excites me. If you have any further questions, please don't hesitate to leave them in the comment section down below. Smack that thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and we'll catch you on the next one. Cheers, everybody.